Hello and welcome to the Commander's Quarters. I'm your host, Mitch. Glad to have you here. Here at the Commander's Quarters, we're all about Commander on a budget. Today's episode is going to be on a Commander topic. These episodes can range from topics on the format in general to current news. This show and episodes like this one are possible because of viewers like you. So if you're looking for some easy ways to help support the show, make sure you like this episode and share it with friends. And make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss any new episodes. You can also go check out our playmats and other merchandise at thecommanderscquarters.com. Thank you to everyone who's already purchased our merchandise. It really does help support the channel. Another easy way to support this channel is by using our TCG player affiliate links. So make sure that you're looking for those links in the description whenever you're buying a deck or just individual cards. And the final way that you can support this show is by supporting us directly by becoming a patron. There are many benefits to being a patron, and I truly couldn't do this without all of their support. So today there was a huge announcement from the Rules Committee. Both Iona Shield of Emeria and Paradox Engine were banned, and Painter Servant was unbanned. Now, we actually haven't had any ban list updates for quite some time. The last ban list updates were in 2017, where Leovold was banned and Protean Hulk was unbanned. Those changes back then definitely made an impact on the Commander format, but I think today's changes might have an even bigger impact than those did. Both Paradox Engine and Iona see a good amount of play in Commander, and I'm sure there are plenty of effective cards out there that pair really well with Painter Servant. One that initially comes to mind is Grindstone. Effectively, you can just mill someone out with this combo. Regardless, there are going to be plenty of opinions out there on whether these changes are good or bad. Commander players are going to have a lot of different reactions, and understandably so. Both Paradox Engine and Iona are pretty expensive cards. Before today's banning, Paradox Engine was around $40, and Iona was around $13, which still isn't very cheap. Commander players that play with these cards might have already spent a good amount of money on them. With this ban list update, those cards now can't be played in Commander anymore. The prices of these cards have already started to drop, and Paradox Engine is all the way down to around $14 from what I'm seeing. On top of that, they may have a deck that's built completely around one of these cards, so they may just have to completely take that deck apart. Now on the other side of this, there's definitely people who've been waiting for this day to come. Some people just don't like playing against cards like these because they don't see them as inherently fair cards. Or at least they don't see them as ones that tend to lead to the types of Commander games that they enjoy playing. And with the Painter Servant unbanning, some people may be excited to brew around this unique card that has been banned for so long. But on the other hand, there might be people that never want to play against this card. Again, with announcements like this, there are going to be a lot of different reactions depending on what your perspective is. But no matter what your initial reaction to this announcement is, there are a few things that I will encourage you to keep in mind. The people in the Rules Committee are human and they have an impossible job. Both the Rules Committee and the Commander Advisory Group do the best job that they possibly can. They all have different perspectives and they're all working for the same thing. They want to make the Commander format the best that it can be. There is absolutely no way that they can make any kind of decision that is going to make every single Commander player happy. Banning one card might make the game more fun for some people, but it's going to take away fun from others. The same is true when it comes to unbanning a card too. They definitely aren't making any of these decisions lightly. They put a lot of time and effort into working to keep the Commander format as healthy as they can from their perspective. I have already seen far too many toxic comments on social media directed towards some of the decision makers. Even if you don't agree with the decisions, keep your comments constructive. Toxic comments have no place in the Magic community, so hold yourself to a higher standard. Commander is a format that is enjoyed by many people with a lot of different perspectives. If you have your own playgroup, you can play however you want still. Your group can ban or unban any cards that you agree to. If you want to keep using Paradox Engine or Iona, just discuss it with your group. If your group doesn't want to see Painter Servant unbanned, then keep it banned. And if your group wants other cards banned or unbanned, go ahead and do that too. Many people have been arguing that Biorhythm should be unbanned for quite some time. So if your group wants that unbanned, go ahead, there's absolutely nothing stopping you. One of the most appealing things about Commander is that it's a casual format, so you can play it in any way that you want to play it. The rules are just set so that when you're in public playing with people that you don't know, everyone knows what to expect. And this is exactly what the Rules Committee is trying to work with to keep the most people happy as they can. Another layer to this whole thing is that there are those out there who like to play competitive EDH, which is otherwise known as CEDH. Now, the Spike Feeders, who are friends of this show, would be a much better resource to talk to on their thoughts on these updates, as well as the cards that they would like to see banned or unbanned. I'm definitely not an expert on CEDH, so I reached out to my friend Jim from the Spike Feeders and asked him. One of the things that he said was that Paradox Engine being banned makes Flash better, which is super unfortunate. Now, with this, he's referring to the very powerful combination between Flash and Protean Hulk. But again, make sure you're checking out the Spike Feeders for more on CEDH, since they are an incredible resource there. So again, there are just a ton of different perspectives on the format, and the Rules Committee has an impossible job as there is no way that every single person can be happy with changes or non-changes. They might ban a card like Paradox Engine, which they consider to be broken in a casual meta, but in CEDH, that card might be keeping another card in check. Now, everyone who plays Commander is going to have their own opinion on what they think is right or wrong for the format. I'm definitely not claiming that I know what's best for the format, but just let me throw in my two cents. I know there are going to be plenty of people that disagree with my perspective, and that is completely fine. I just ask you again to please keep your comments constructive so that a real discussion can be had. Again, toxic comments have no place in the Magic community. So one of the reasons that I love playing budget Magic is that my limitations are already set in with the price. There are certain cards that I simply can't include in my decks because of their price tag. So in my eyes, it's a very good way for me to play quote-unquote fair Magic. There are definitely still broken things that you can do on a budget. But if a card becomes so format warping and good that people are calling it for it to be banned, chances are high that demand for it has already made its price too high for me to include. I see this as a good thing for myself because it restricts my own deck building without need of a ban list. So these ban and unban updates today have absolutely no impact on my deck building since all these cards are too expensive for me to use anyways. Now I know that everyone doesn't play on a budget and that's completely fine. I'm completely fine with playing against people that put thousands of dollars into their decks. Now although I've never built with Paradox Engine or Iona, I've definitely played against them. So if someone puts out a Paradox Engine and just demolishes everyone else with it and then intends to use the exact same deck again, I might just go to another table. That might not be my kind of fun when it comes to playing Commander, but it's definitely someone else's. If I don't want to play against that player or that deck again, I don't have to. There's nothing forcing me to play them again. They're playing within the rules that are set, and that's completely okay. So in general, I just don't like a ban list being a part of Commander at all. I think that in Commander especially, people should be able to play their cards. I used to play Standard, and I would hate that my cards would become essentially useless to me after a set rotated out. Commander is great because you can play pretty much any card that you might have. Now, of course, there can be an exception for silver-bordered cards or conspiracies or those kinds, but for the most part, you can play any card you want. Just because a card's made legal doesn't mean that everyone's going to make a broken deck out of it. With an update like the one that was made today, there are definitely going to be some feel-bads in the near future for some people. I'm sure there are going to be people who don't see this announcement and go into their shop expecting to be able to play their deck. When they go to cast their Paradox Engine, they're going to feel pretty bad when someone else tells them that that card is now illegal in Commander. Since Commander's not a sanctioned format, not every single person is staying up on the ban list every single day. And I think that it's pretty unreasonable to expect every single person to do so. It's a casual format that's intended for fun and allows people to use their cards. Now, the definitions of fun between people are different. People want different things out of this format and want to be able to play it in different ways. No matter what anyone says, no one way is inherently right or wrong. So in my opinion, if someone wants to combo out with Flash Hulk right after the game just started, that's great. I might not be one of them, but there are plenty of people out there that want to do that. If someone else wants to essentially lock everyone else out of the game with Teferi and Knowledge Pool, go for it. Again, I'm not one of them, but there are even people who want to play that way too. And then there are people who want to play jank decks like Everyone Sitting in Chairs Tribal. Just because that deck isn't for me, that doesn't mean that it's wrong. Every single Commander player is entitled to their own opinion and is allowed to enjoy this game however they would like to. The most important part of a Commander game can happen even before the game starts. You need to make sure that you're communicating expectations ahead of time. Try your best to figure out if your decks are compatible to play against each other. A Flash Hulk player and a Chairs Tribal player probably aren't going to have any fun playing against each other. Now let's say that communication didn't happen ahead of time, that's okay. If you don't want to play a second game against someone, that's completely fine. It doesn't mean that they are wrong or a bad person for wanting to play the way that they play. By playing with more and more people, you eventually learn the level and types of decks that you enjoy playing with and against. You also get better at setting expectations ahead of time. And by playing with more and more people, you can meet the people that you actually want to play against. You can form a playgroup and set your own group rules on how you want to play. What I know more than anything, though, is that I want this format to stay healthy so I can continue to enjoy playing Commander. This means that the vast majority of people playing it need to continue to enjoy the format even with decisions like today's being made. I have no idea the exact impact that this update is going to make, but I hope that it's for the better. It might not be the decision that I would have made, but that doesn't mean that it's the wrong decision. What I most fear about decisions like these is the potential of having a divided format where a common rule set isn't agreed upon. When you're playing in playgroup, you can have any rule set that you want. But when you're going out to play in public, it's crucial to have a common rule set for the long-term health of the format. And that's precisely what the Rules Committee as well as the Commander Advisory Group is trying to do. They're trying to make it so that we all have a common rule set that everyone can live with. Again, making this rule set perfect for everyone is impossible. In fact, there are plenty of disputes within the Rules Committee as well as the Commander Advisory Group on what these rules should be. At the end of the day, everyone can't get what they want and we all have to live with that. That's simply a fact of life, but you just learn to adjust and adapt. If your favorite card gets banned, talk with your playgroup to see if they won't still mind if you play it. If not, make an adjustment and move forward. You might find a new favorite card by having to replace the old one. You can also use these updates as an opportunity to bring up cards that you actually want unbanned with your group. You might be surprised that they're also in agreement and you might be able to unban a few cards. Commander is an ever-evolving thing. New cards come into the format all the time. Decks change, metas change, and playstyles can change too. And if you want to see something else changed, talk about it. So let's keep having these kinds of discussions in an open and constructive manner to work towards keeping our format healthy and thriving. And at the end of the day, every single Commander player wants a healthy Commander format. That, and Wayfarer's Bauble needs to be reprinted. So hashtag reprint the ramp. But jokes aside, I really want to hear your thoughts on these updates today. Do you think Paradox Engine and Iona should have been banned? And do you think Painter Servant should have been unbanned? And what are your thoughts on the ban list in general? Let me know with some constructive comments below. And make sure that you're following us on social media for more updates and sneak peeks on future episodes. Links to our social media accounts can be found in the description. Also in the description below is a link to the Commander's Quarters Patreon page, and I just want to say a quick thank you to the patrons who have subscribed so far. There are many benefits to being a patron for the Commander's Quarters, including being able to vote on future Commanders for deck techs. There's even a general level tier where you get your own personalized deck tech dedicated to you. I truly couldn't do this without all of your support, so from the bottom of my heart, thank you. If you haven't already, make sure that you like and subscribe to the channel. And while you're at it, check out some of our other episodes on budget deck techs, quest for quarters episodes, commander topics, and creators quarters. And with that, I'm out of here. Thanks again, and have a good one.